Hello and welcome.
What's going on, everybody? It's Taylor Roberts, and today we got the Weeknd After Hours short film. I am super excited. The last time the Weeknd had dropped a short film was Mania. And that was during his Starboy era. I mean, in that video, it was super dope. We got an idea of what this world was gonna be like, that the Starboy album was gonna take place in. And it gave us snippets of some songs that we hadn't heard before. And I'm hoping that this After Hours short film is gonna kinda do the same thing. I hope it gives us an idea of what this world that this album is gonna take place in. I hope we get to hear some new music. That would be dope. Make sure you subscribe, comment, like, share, all that good stuff. And I'm just gonna get into it, because I've been waiting to watch this video, because I always wait until I make one of these videos, because it's the first reaction, obviously. So it has to be a first reaction. Okay, he's at his Jimmy Kimmel performance.
That was great, thank you so much.
That's pretty cool that they shot this during that performance.
Thanks for watching. Good
night. See how that smile changed real quick? It was almost as if he was putting off like a fake persona, and as soon as he walked off stage, it just went, just switched, and something's going on. Something's going on in his head right now. Okay, there's a little bit of glimpse of some new music. Obviously his cut is still fresh. That's a cool shot. That's a really nice shot. I always like silhouette shots in films. I don't know why, I love them so much, especially if you're creative with them. And this one's pretty creative. And that, you guys hear that like guitar? Is that part of After Hours song, or is that like a new snippet of a possible instrumental from another song? I don't know. That's gotta be from another song, right? Ooh. That's definitely, it's like an As You Are beat. Oh yeah. Something's definitely going on in there. That's the same face I make when I gotta go to school. Be walking out of my apartment. So one of the things I noticed differently is they are showing us some new snippets of of music that's going to be in the album. But unlike how it was in Mania, where it was very upfront, you could clearly hear everything. Everything seems to be pushed in the back to where we're not really hearing individual tracks, but more of like a mashup of a couple of different tracks, which is nice because it piques your interest and it gets you excited about the song, but at the same time, like, you still don't know what it's going to sound like on the actual album, which I think is a pretty genius move. He's going into sad boy mode. He's gripping his glove like that. They showed us that specifically for a reason. You just don't show shots in a film and not have it be no meaning in it. What do you guys think of? It's almost as if he's like trying to hold something back, you know, like when you have something and you're kind of just like fiddling with yourself. Sounds weird, but you're trying to hold something back. Okay, there's that little colorful flower thing again. That went 0 to 100 really quick. I'm never gonna get over this beat though. What's he being dragged by? Like he lost his mind. That's kind of creepy. Anybody here when the elevator doors opened up? It was like that scream right before the drop in the hills. He just killed those people? He definitely just killed those people. Okay, well, I guess we have an idea of what he's been running from in the past two music videos. Jesus. I definitely think that was better than the Mania short film that they came out with before that. It gave us a nice little introduction into the world, and I liked how they started off with the Jimmy Kimmel performance. It put it in reality, you know? Since we all witnessed the performance in real life timeline, it's kind of cool how they transitioned that real life timeline and make it seem like all of this happened in our actual reality. Abel and his acting, man, his acting is good. As myself, as a filmmaker, and as an actor as well, being able to act with dialogue is difficult, but being able to act without dialogue and using emotion, facial emotions, and body language is tough thing to do. And so hats off to Abel for being able to pull that off. It was really good. As from a filmmaking side of things, I think the last three videos have been shot by the same director. I can't remember his name at the moment. But I really love the cinematography that they've been using. I really love the colors, the matching of the red and the greens. And usually, if you look at red and greens, it's more of like Christmas colors, you know? And red and green is used a lot in Christmas movies. But here, they're using it as this sickly, haunting, horror-y type vibe. And I really like the the choice. So apparently it seems like these last something has been hunting him down, and it's almost like he's suffering from like a split personality or a possession of some kind. Some sort of force has been chasing him, and it eventually took him over in the very end, because he's like a psycho, just straight up blank staring in the elevator, and then he looks at that dude, and then you just hear, you know, sounds like he's murdering them, which maybe he wasn't murdering him. Maybe they were just ecstatic that they met the Weeknd in the elevator, and they were going crazy. I don't know. But this was a nice little drop to just get everybody prepared, and I'm excited. I really am. I'm definitely going to have to watch the video again just to see if there is, you know, some stuff that's really like buried in the shots that I missed that could, you know, offer up a little bit more clues about this world. But thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. Make sure you subscribe, like, comment, share. And let me know what you think about the video in the comments. And last but not least, 2 weeks until the album drops, you know I'm going to be doing a reaction to that album. Don't know how I'm going to do it yet, but I'm going to do a reaction to that album for sure. So make sure you guys subscribe and stay tuned. And thanks again for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.